coming to help.
Oh, what a block by Capella!
What am I even... Why am I uploading this video now? M-Bone, dude, the conference semifinals is halfway over. Anyway, guys, I might be late on this video, or maybe I'm right on time. With the NBA conference semifinals being just about halfway through, I thought it'd be a perfect time to give you my predictions and thoughts on the remainder of each of the four series. We're gonna take a look at the East first, and we have to start with the Milwaukee Bucks versus the Boston Celtics, down 3-1. No team seems to be in more trouble than the Boston Celtics right now. After winning game one in Milwaukee, everything has fallen apart for the Celtics and Paul Pierce.
Whoa, so is this over?
No, listen, I think it's over.
This series is over.
Yeah, they
one
lost.
One game? You just sat there and said that they could win an NBA championship.
Yeah, I did say that, but
one game.
I think
I can't even explain how impressed I've been with the Bucks and Giannis. I'll admit it, I was hesitant on how this team would perform in the playoffs, being so young and having a superstar that hadn't had much playoff experience. But boy, have I been wrong. Giannis became the first Bucks player to record at least 35 points and 15 rebounds in a playoff game since the great Kareem. He's been unstoppable, looking like a grown-ass man playing against a bunch of high schoolers. Not only that, especially in game four, the Bucks just wanted it more. They played with more heart and made the big plays when needed. It doesn't help either when George Hill outscored Boston's entire bench for the second straight game, this time 15-7. He has outscored the Celtics reserves 36-23 during games 3 and 4. Saying all this, I am still going to stick with my Eastern Conference champion prediction. I know the chances of a team coming back down 3-1 are very, very unlikely, actually just a 4% chance. And the last team to do it was, of course, LeBron in the 2016 NBA Finals. At the end of the day, I've backed Kyrie Irving since day one. I may look like an idiot saying this, but I'm gonna stick with my Celtics. Well, not my Celtics, I'm a Bulls fan, so. But my prediction of the Celtics. So I'm gonna say the Celtics are gonna come back and bring it back. Most likely they'll probably lose, you know, game five in freaking Milwaukee, but you never know. Up next in the Eastern Conference, we have Toronto versus Philadelphia. As I'm recording this video, the series is currently tied 2-2, heading back to Toronto after just yet another incredible performance by Kawhi Leonard. Clutch shot after clutch shot. Kawhi keeps showing us that come playoff time, you can make the argument that no one shines more than him. We saw it in San Antonio, and we continue to see it with the Raptors. Even though I love Jimmy Butler, and I believe the 76ers have one of the most talented rosters in all of the NBA, I'm going to ride with Kawhi and the Raptors. Hopefully Lowry and the rest of the supporting cast can help a bit more than they have. Knowing Jimmy Butler, you know he's gonna bring it for the rest of the series. I am so excited to see how this one turns out. Moving over to the West, we have Golden State versus Houston. Tied 2-2 after two huge wins. James Harden and company did what they needed to do. Everyone knew if they went down 3-1, the series was over. Now the question is, can they snag a game in Oakland? If they want revenge from last year's heartbreak, they're gonna have to. James Harden is playing like James Harden. I feel like a lot of this has to do with his conditioning. He seems to be in such better shape than he was last year. Now on the other side of the ball, Kevin Durant has balled out the entire playoffs. Steph Curry shot the ball a bit better. Klay Thompson still hasn't done much. I am very, very concerned about the fact that if Curry does really, you know, start to get hot and Durant's playing the way that, you know, Kevin Durant plays, that the Warriors could potentially, you know, win the next two games. But I'm still going to back my Houston Rockets. Well, I say my, they're not my team. But I did make a video about 2 weeks ago saying why I thought the Houston Rockets were going to beat the Golden State Warriors. So for that case, I'm going to ride with the Rockets. I'm thinking at least, I definitely it's going to go to a game seven, I assume. It's been a great series. It got a bit chippy last night, so we'll see what happens. I will say, dude, the rebounding has been such a huge key. The Warriors dominated the glass, especially the offensive glass, game one and game two, and the Rockets were able to, you know, turn that around for the two home games. I feel like Capella has been a lot better. He is such a huge key to this Rockets team, and we'll see what happens. Again, another great series. And last but not certainly least, Denver versus Portland. This has been the most exciting NBA playoff series so far. As I record this, the series is tied 2-2. after Denver won a massive road game in Portland. Can we take a moment to just appreciate the greatness of Game 3's 4-overtime game? Without a doubt, one of the best NBA games I've ever watched. Shout out to Rodney Hood, who became the unsung hero of the game. Jamal Murray is so damn good. I still remember watching him at Kentucky and just knew he was going to be a stud. I really feel like the Spurs series was so good for this young Nugget team. They learned so much in that series. Saying that, I'm still going to back Dame and the Trailblazers. I hope we get 7 games. Regardless, both teams are evenly matched and it is shown through 4 games. I should also mention, I'm not sure how the Joker was able to play in Game 4 after recording 65 minutes in that 4-overtime game. 65 minutes. That is just way too many minutes that anyone should ever have to play on the basketball court. I'm exhausted just thinking about that. Just crazy, man. Anyway, guys, the first round was a bit dull, but the second round has had some incredible matchups. If you guys are not watching, you can catch on ESPN, TNT, and I think ABC as well. Make sure you guys do keep up with all the action. Thank you guys for watching the video. Let me know in the comments down below your predictions on each series and who you think is going to win in advance. Thank you for watching the video. It has been your boy, M-Bone HD, and I will catch you guys later. Peace.
Simmons pressing up on Leonard.
See,
switches. Fires a long one.
Oh, my.
Nothing
oh, my.
But net.